Now, fourth, origin of simple organic compounds. Origin of simple organic compounds. In the earlier atmosphere, there was volcanic eruptions. And due to the volcanic eruption, lava comes out, and this lava consisted of red hot metal. Volcanic eruption hua, volcanic eruption se lava nikla, lava mein red hot metals present the. So when these red hot metal combined with or reacted with the carbon, they form carbide. And when this carbide reacted with water vapor, they form ammonia. This is the first organic compound formed. Pehla organic compound primitive atmosphere of the earth mein jo bana tha, wo tha methane. Now, hame hydrogen, carbon and nitrogen. These three elements were present and these three elements combined together and form HCl, hydrogen cyanide. And this was the second organic compound or the simple second simple organic compound we can say was HCl. So chemical phase mein pehle atomic phase tha. Atomic phase mein sare elements atomic form mein present the. Atomic form se molecules bane to molecular phase aaya. Molecular phase ke baad mein simple inorganic compounds ka molecules se simple inorganic compounds ka formation hua and simple inorganic compounds se simple organic compounds ka formation hua. Ab when we match it with the earlier conditions of the earth, jab when the life was originating on the earth, what were the conditions? They were high temperature tha, to high temperature ke time par atomic phase hua, thik. And high temperature ke baad mein there was a rainfall. Temperature ko kam karne ke liye rainfall. So now we will study about the rainfall. Now jab in simple inorganic compounds bane, at that time the temperature of the earth was very high. Estimated temperature at that time was 800 degrees Celsius. Temperature of the earth was around 800 degrees Celsius at that time. So because of the radiations or because of the condensation of the water vapor, rainfall chalu hua. So water vapor ka condensation hua, it started into raining. And when it started raining, then that rain when come to the earth, it was again converted into the water vapor. Condensation of water vapor, it started raining, rainfall, and again that water converted into the water vapor, and again that water vapor condensed and rainfall occurs. So this cycle again and again happens. A condensation of water, water vapor, then it turned into the rainfall. Rainfall होने के बाद में again that water vapor condensed and turned into the rainfall. So this cycle happened for the years after years, and it resulted into the torrential rainfall. So rainfall हुआ. Years after years, बहुत सालों तक rainfall होता रहा, होता रहा, होता रहा, and that converted into the torrential rainfall. So, torrential rainfall होने के बाद में, when the temperature of the earth was reduced up to 100 degrees Celsius, it is estimated that torrential rainfall हुआ, उसके बाद में earth का temperature reduced होकर 100 degrees Celsius हो गया. तो at the temperature of 100 degrees Celsius, earth started to collect the water, or it started making the water bodies. इतना पानी गिरा तो water bodies तो form होंगी ही, lakes and rivers and seas, all the oceans, all this will be formed. So earlier simple organic compounds थे, earth पर पानी नहीं था. After rainfall, rainfall होने के बाद में all these simple inorganic compounds and the simple organic compounds, they will be mixed into these water bodies. So, जब simple organic, this is a mixture of the simple inorganic compounds and the organic compounds into the hot water is called as broth. This we termed it as broth, and this is called as the broth formation. पहले इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स बने, ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स बने, फिर रेनफॉल हुआ. तो ये सारे मेटल्स और ये सारे कंपाउंड्स, दे स्टार्ट एक्यूमुलेटिंग इन दैट वाटर बॉडीज, एंड दैट हॉट वाटर बॉडी कंटेनिंग ऑल दिस एलिमेंट्स इज टर्म्ड एज ब्रॉथ. दिस होल प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज ब्रॉथ फॉर्मेशन. नाउ sixth, a region of organic compounds. Origin of the organic compound. These were origin of early organic compound. These are the early organic compound, and this is the origin of simple organic compounds. So, early organic compounds was methane and HCl. And simple organic compounds. Simple organic compounds कैसे बने? बहुत सारे elements from these inorganic elements and the organic elements, they combine together in the different ways and they form many of the simple organic compound. What were they? Glucose, amino acids, fatty acids and glycerol. And nucleoside, sugar plus phosphate. These were some simple organic compounds which were formed. Now, formation of complex organic compound. Complex organic compound. So, when these complex organic compound has been formed by the polymerization in the simple organic compound, is formed by polymerization reaction in this simple organic compound. So, by the polymerization of the glucose, we will get carbohydrates and by the polymerization of amino acids we'll get the proteins, by fatty acid and glycerol we will get fats, and nucleoside sugar and phosphate will give us nucleic acid. These were the four organic compounds or the complex organic compounds which were formed in the primitive earth. So, atomic phase, molecular phase, simple organic, inorganic compounds, when a simple early organic compounds were formed, rainfall, and after the rainfall, simple organic and complex organic compounds were formed. So, complex organic compound form hone ke baad mein, there was the origin of protobionts. These protobionts are the precursor, can be considered as the precursors of first life or first cell. These are only the precursors of the first life or the first cell. They should not be considered as the actual first life or the first cell. Okay. These are the precursors of the first life and the first cell. Now, these protobionts are divided into two types or two things, coacervates and microspheres. Protobionts, precursor of the first life or the first cell, are of two types, coacervates and the microspheres. First we will discuss about the coacervates. Coacervates are formed by the combination, or they are formed by when carbohydrates, proteins and water. Carbohydrates, proteins and water, they are shaken up. So, they form a colloidal structure called coacervates. Colloidal structure. Carbohydrates, proteins and waters, when these three things are taken and shaken up vigorously, then they form a colloidal structure that is called as coacervates. What are the properties of the coacervates? That coacervates shows growth and development. They show only some metabolic processes, and they do not show cell division or any type of the division. Why they do not show any type of cell division? Because of no plasma membrane. Or because of the lack of outer membrane, they do not show any kind of cell division in the coacervates. Now, second was the microspheres. Microspheres, when carbohydrates, proteins, lipids and water combined together and heated at 130 to 180 degrees Celsius and then cooled down. They form microspheres. And one more thing, the concept of this coacervate was given by Oparin, and the concept of the microsphere was given by Sidney Fox. Oparin and Sidney Fox. And what were the properties of this microsphere? They were also showing growth and development. And they also used to show some metabolic processes. And because of the presence of lipid, they were showing the presence of plasma membrane, and they show some divisions like budding. Some divisions like budding was shown by the microspheres. This was not shown in the coacervates because of the lack of plasma membrane, and in this, due to the presence of lipid, microspheres form a plasma membrane around them and they started dividing. So, coacervate is considered as the first cell or the first precursor cell. So, coacervates may these were containing only some basic properties like growth, development, and they were showing only some of the metabolic properties. They were not showing all the properties like reproduction, and they were not showing the electron transport chain like metabolic processes, and they were not the control of the nucleic acid over them. That nucleic, up to here there was not an existence of the nucleic acid, but after some time there was the formation of the nucleic acid also, and nucleic acid started taking the control over the coacervates. Jaise hi nucleic acid ka formation hua, then these coacervates converted into the another life form or the another cell form called as eubionts. Coacervates say by some modifications in it, they converted into the eubionts, and they are considered as the actual first cell or the actual first life is called as eubiont. This was developed from the coacervates by some modifications in it, and this eubiont consisted of these nucleic acids also. Now, after the formation of the eubiont, how first life was evolved? That first life means to say that all the metabolic processes and all the organic and inorganic compounds should present in that living form. That is the concept behind saying the first life. So, first life kaise bani? So, in eubionts, all the complex organic material were present. So, protein was also present in that. So, kuch protein jo the, they converted into the enzyme, and they started doing or started catalyzing the reaction. Kuch proteins bane in the eubiont, some proteins were present. So, by chance kya hua, kuch proteins convert ho gaye into the enzymes. Enzyme ki to property hoti hai to catalyze the reaction. तो उनके रिएक्शन को कैटलाइज करने से बहुत सारे मॉलिक्यूल्स और द ऑर्गेनिक मॉलिक्यूल्स बनने लगे यूबायोंट में। तो इन सब बहुत सारे मॉलिक्यूल्स के बनने से दे स्टार्टेड प्रोसेसिंग द फूड एंड दे स्टार्टेड प्रोड्यूसिंग एनर्जी। यूबायोंट बना, यूबायोंट में न्यूक्लिक एसिड एग्जिस्टेड, न्यूक्लिक एसिड एग्जिस्टेड इन द यूबायोंट एंड प्रोटीन प्रेजेंट था। प्रोटीन से कुछ एंजाइम्स बन गए एंड दैट एंजाइम हेल्प्ड टू दिस यूबायोंट टू प्रोसेस द फूड एंड टू प्रोड्यूस मोर एंड मोर एनर्जी। तो द बेस्ट यूबायोंट वॉज सिलेक्टेड एंड दैट वॉज फर्दर इवॉल्व। दिस इज हाउ द फर्स्ट लाइफ वॉज इवॉल्व एंड द न्यूक्लिक एसिड विच वॉज विच न्यूक्लिक एसिड अपियर्ड अर्लियर, आरएनए। आरएनए वॉज द फर्स्ट न्यूक्लिक एसिड विच वॉज अपियर्ड बिफोर द डीएनए। आरएनए वॉज अपियर्ड, वाई आरएनए इज अपियर्ड बिफोर डीएनए और वॉट प्रूफ दैट आरएनए हैज बीन अपियर्ड बिफोर द डीएनए। बिकॉज RNA has a simpler structure. RNA का structure simple होता है. That this is the first proof that RNA has been appeared before the DNA. And the enzyme ribozyme, it is the form of RNA. RNA ही एक ऐसा न्यूक्लिक इज द मटेरियल, जेनेटिक मटेरियल। आरएनए इज द ओनली जेनेटिक मटेरियल विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द एंजाइम फॉर्म। इट इज द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल और द सेकेंड प्रूफ दैट आरएनए अपियर्ड बिफोर द डीएनए एज अ जेनेटिक मटेरियल। दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द केमिकल फेज ऑफ द थियोरी। केमिकल फेज में अटोमिक फेज, मोलिकुलर फेज, इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स बने, ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स बने, प्रोटोबायोंट्स आए, कोएसरवेट्स एंड माइक्रोस्फियर्स वर फॉर्म्ड एंड फाइनली द फर्स्ट लाइफ दैट इज यूबायोंट हैज बीन फॉर्म्ड इन द केमिकल फेज। तो दिस वॉज ओनली द थियोरिटिकल पार्ट। वी कैन से दैट ओपेरिन एंड हेल्डन ने सिर्फ थियोरिटिकली ही बताया कि ये सब हुआ था अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर ऑब्जर्वेशन। बट दिस केमिकल फेज वॉज एक्सपेरिमेंटली प्रूव्ड बाय टू साइंटिस्ट। एक्सपेरिमेंटल प्रूफ ऑफ केमिकल थियोरी और द केमिकल फेज ऑफ द मॉडर्न थियोरी। एक्सपेरिमेंटल प्रूफ, दिस केमिकल फेज वॉज proved by two scientists, Urey and Stanley Miller. These two scientists experimentally proved the chemical phase of this theory. What they did at the time of what were the conditions when life was originated? There was high temperature and lighter elements were present in the form of gases, and the heavier elements iron and nickel were forming the crust of the earth, and energy was produced by the UV and lightning. So when the conditions were not so favorable for the origin of life, at that time also the life originated. So this was proved by Urey and Miller. What they did, they performed an experiment. They took a round bottom flask they took this round bottom flask and they inserted two electrodes in it. And he passed electric current through these two electrodes. And in earlier time, there were only these gases were present, methane, ammonia and hydrogen. Only these gases were present in the earlier time. So he took water vapor, ammonia and methane. He took these three gases in the ratio of 2:1:2. You can remember it as VAM, or water vapor, ammonia and methane. You can remember these three gases as VAM. In the ratio of 2:1:2, he took three gases which were present in the earlier or the, in the primitive atmosphere. He took these three gases and in a round bottom flask, he inserted two electrodes and passed the electric current. For what he passed the electric current? As a source of energy. At that time, we were getting energy from the UV rays and from the lightning. Here, we will get the energy from the electric spark. And he also, or they also maintained the temperature of this round bottom flask up to 800 degrees Celsius by passing the electric current. This 800 degrees Celsius is similar temperature to the earlier environment. Now, we will just look about the apparatus. This round bottom flask was connected to the narrow elongated tube, and below the round bottom flask there was present a condenser. This was for inlet and this was for water outlet. Inlet. And this narrow tube is connected to the U-shaped trap. Here one knob is present, and this U-shaped trap is connected to the one boiling water flask. This was the apparatus of the Miller and Urey experiment. Now, this was the apparatus of the Miller and Urey experiment. This is the condenser. This is a round bottom flask. Electrodes, condenser, U-shaped trap, boiling water flask, and this is to maintain the vacuum. and this is again connected to the round bottom flask. Now ये तो हमने समझ लिया कि एक राउंड बॉटम फ्लास्क था इन विच द टू इलेक्ट्रोड्स वर इंसर्टेड एंड द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट वाज पास्ड. इलेक्ट्रिक करंट पास्ड होने से लाइटनिंग हुआ. दैट लाइटनिंग इज यूज्ड एज अ सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी एंड हियर द टेम्परेचर इज मेंटेन्ड अप टू द 800 डिग्री सेल्सियस. And according to the environment or according to the primitive environment, the gases are present water vapor, ammonia and methane in the ratio of 2:1:2. Now, this round bottom flask is connected to the narrow tube, and in this narrow tube below the round bottom flask there is a condenser. What is the significance of this condenser? Condenser is used to maintain the temperature or to lower the temperature. Earlier atmosphere में क्या हुआ था? Lightning के कारण temperature बढ़ता गया. And there happens after temperature increase होने के बाद में torrential rainfall हुआ. Torrential rainfall से temperature कम हुआ. So, this condenser is similar to that of torrential rainfall to reduce the temperature of this round bottom flask. And whatever activity is going on here, from there, some liquid or some water is coming out in this round bottom flask. So, from this, the liquid or the extract which is coming out from the activity which is going on here, that extract is cools down here with the help of this condenser. Cool down hone ke baad mein this condenser, this extract comes in this U-trap. This U-trap is used for taking off that extract from time to time for checking. यहाँ पर आएगा तो उसे टाइम टू टाइम चेक करने के लिए दैट व्हाट एवर व्हाट द मटेरियल्स हैव बीन फॉर्म्ड इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट और इन दिस एपरेटस दैट विल बी चेक्ड. एंड फ्रॉम दिस यू ट्रैप व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ दिस बॉइलिंग वाटर फ्लास्क. इन द प्रिमिटिव एटमोस्फियर देर वॉज वाटर वेपर. For water vapor के लिए ये boiling water flask, to fulfill the need of water vapor, this boiling water flask has been used. And this to inlet of the vacuum, it is why it is used, because in the earlier atmosphere there was no oxygen. Oxygen नहीं था, तो that's why this vacuum is used to evacuate the oxygen from this apparatus. So, यहां पे से जो extract निकला यहां पर cool down हुआ. After that, if it is formed or then it will be taken up from this U-trap, and if it is not formed then it will move to the boiling water flask to take the water vapor, and from it will again move to the round bottom flask. So, like this the process is continuing, and when the extract has formed some of the materials into it, then it will be taken out from this U-trap. And they observed this experiment for the 7 days. After 7 days, they started taking the extract from this U-trap. So, isme se wo extract nikalenge, and what they had seen that there were some amino acids like glutamic acid were formed in this extract, glycine was found in this extract, and alanine. Like this, many of the amino acid were formed in this extract, in this Miller and Urey experiment, and also some of the acids like acetic acid, formic acid, and certain acids were formed, and nucleic acid were also formed like DNA, RNA, and organic compounds like glucose, proteins, or the carbohydrate, proteins, fats, etc. These were also found. So, what they concluded that ki, when there was the primitive atmosphere, according to the primitive atmosphere, they arranged their apparatus and they formed. In the primitive atmosphere, what we had found that they had formed some of the organic material also, some amino acids, proteins are formed by the amino acids, some amino acids were formed, glucose was formed, fats and the nucleic acids were also formed. So, jaisa result hume wahan par mila tha ya jaise hume wahan par products bane the in the primitive atmosphere, waise hi products inke experiment mein bhi hume dekhne ko mile. So, we concluded that ki isi tarah se kuch procedure wahan par bhi hui hogi. So, the same products has been formed. This was the experiment of Miller and Urey.